more you can't play Yu-Gi-Oh cards. Oh. Well, you know, hold on. It's that, you know what? God, super Canadian. You're like half right, man. Dude, is Yu-Gi-Oh just, oh my God, chat. It really makes you think. Is Yu-Gi-Oh just at the point where they cannot save the physical card game without blowing this shit up? Because I actually thought about that, right? With Super Canadian, I don't know if he's alluding to this, right? But the problem is, Konami has, they backed themselves into a door with, like, power creep, right? I'm gonna explain exactly what I mean. So if Konami gives us cards that aren't very strong, then the entire community, including the people with the biggest voices, right? The creators, they're all like, this card's trash. We hate it. But if you make the cards too good, then they just become more of you can't play Yu-Gi-Oh! And it just further adds to the whole, like, the game being decided with one turn, 10 negates. Like, all right, you made 10 negates, I don't have Dark Ruin no more, scoop. Like, what? How the fuck do they get out of it, chat? Other than, as I've said before, having, like, a full era, like, 3 straight years of just printing bad cards. Like, or basically, what is it, like, speed duels where every card sucks? you have to have like 3 straight years of every card being like this, chat. Because that, at that point, like, you can, it's like at that point you've washed away, you've like reverse power creep, and you've like all the older cards. I guess you can, like, the ones that are still really good, you can like just ban them or like limit them and stuff like that. Like, what do they do, chat? Because Super Canadian, yeah, I don't think he meant to, but he brings up a good point. Like, if you make the card good, like, if you make it, like, Harpy's Featherstorm like I wanted, okay, well, then it's just another you can't play Yu-Gi-Oh! For a turn card. But if it's this, then, like, who the fuck wants to play this? I mean, it's okay, I guess. Like, I wouldn't play it in Dark Magician, honestly. Let's see. 2020, Trash Without Pens. Mechanic that should have never been created, by the way. Tens are based on Tablet of Memories, which also had the God cards on them. Where the Obelisk and Slifer cards make more cards based off attacks. Fist of Fate and Thunder Force, like Blaze Cannon. What they did with Merrick, Rylaguise, maybe they're leaving it open for them to. I mean, that would kind of be shitty, right, chat? If Konami was saying, oh yeah, we're gonna make Obelisk and Slifer support in the future, but you're only gonna get them in a legendary duelist. Like, maybe they could do that. Who else thought we were getting a Blue Eyes version of Dragoon? Not in the same set. That would just, there's no reason for that. Red Eyes Dark Dragoon is good enough to sell the entire Megatons. There's no reason for them to make another broken, like, all-powerful. I mean, don't get me wrong, they can make Blue Eyes Dragoon or Blue Eyes White Dragoon. I guess it would be Blue Eyes Light Dragoon. They can make that, but, like, there's no need to give it to us right now. Like, the tens are already gonna sell because people want Dragoon. Konami is such a cock tease sometimes. Konami got lazy again, almost like they know Dark Dragoon will be a $150 card. I heard it's an ultra rare. I can't confirm that, obviously. Speedo's already fucked. Just adopt set rotation? Yeah. So set rotation is a very interesting concept, and Magic has it. Does Pokemon have set rotation? I think Pokemon does too. Yeah, if you have set rotation, then you don't need power creep in your game, period. The problem with set rotation is, from a business model, Konami makes a lot of money, guys, off reprints. So, like, do you just never have, that's the thing, like, do you never just have reprints in those games? Because what is the point of reprinting a card if you can't play it? Like, you guys know how, like, Konami has reprint sets every single year, chat. Like, the Megatons, they used to have the Gold Series, Battles of Legends. Like, these are sets specifically just to fucking sell us the same cards, but it make them either shinier or easy to get. And that is what's it called? Starlight. Yeah, now they have fucking Starlight reprints. Like, think about how much money Konami makes on reprints, chat. If you put set rotation in the game, okay, there's no need for, once Lightning Storm basically power creeps out or set rotates out. What set is Lightning Storm in, chat? Is that in Ignition Assault? Yeah, like, once Ignition Assault like sets out or set releases out, I never need to buy that card ever again, boys. Never. Fuck that $100 card. I don't have to buy it. I can just wait it out. Like, I don't know if that works, chat. Set rotation might not work in Yu-Gi-Oh. You can bring the poison back called Max C. How to stomp, you can't play Yu-Gi-Oh format. You counter with no more say no, then say no to that, then power creep. This is Chainlink, this is hard, this is complicated. Then power creep the no, and again, etc., etc. Chainlink to the I don't really Chainlink, I have no idea what the fuck you just said. To be honest. Rephrase that. What's up, Hero 101? How you doing tonight? They reprinted Exciton Knight without banning him before. Well, I mean, yeah, but like, chat again. Like, okay, just think. Yu-Gi-Oh has set rotation right now. So we would probably do what, four sets, chat? Four core booster sets. What are we on? We're on Eternity Code. Actually, are we on Rise of the Duelist, chat? Let's just say we're on Rise of the Duelist. So you can play Rise of the Duelist, Eternity Code, Ignition Assault, and what came before Ignition Assault? Whatever that set is. So chat, you only get to play Lightning Storm for two more sets. That means if you can't afford Lightning Storm, you could just wait it out. Now granted, I guess you might be like, Cat, I don't want to wait 6 months, you know, and not play Yu-Gi-Oh! TCG player. Like, to me, that would kind of hurt Konami's business model long term. Because Konami, even though they don't make money, chat, off card sales in the secondary market, Konami makes money off players going out buying boxes and boxes of Lightning Storms, which they would still get. But when Konami reprints Lightning Storm, chat, in whatever fucking set that they make it in, Konami makes a lot of money off that, just because Lightning Storm's getting reprinted. I'm just using Lightning Storm because it's like one of the more expensive cards in Yu-Gi-Oh right now. Like if they had set rotation, chat, they would basically it's a Chaos Impact, is it? No, it's not. Oh, you're saying the set before. Lightning Storm. Wait, is it called Lightning Regeki? Am I actually just trolling? What the fuck is this card called? Oh wait, maybe I can't spell. Lightning Storm? This is it. Okay. I'm like, maybe I just actually can't spell. I'm like, I'm pretty sure the card's called Lightning Storm. All right, here we go. Ignition Assault. Okay, that's what I thought. Ignition Assault. I don't want the Starlight Rare. Yeah, chat. Okay, so it's a $100 card. But in a few sets, Konami would no longer be able to make money off of this card. Like, no players would go out and buy special editions to try to pull it. They wouldn't be able to reprint it in Battles of Legends next year or whatever. It would take away a lot of money from them. I mean, and granted, I don't really care about how much money Konami makes, because I'm a player, so that's none of my concern. However, like, it's not really much incentive for them to do it. It screws over vendors, so it's a win-win. Moving to set rotation would kill the current market. F the market. And the player base would riot. I think that I agree with. Even though I don't really care about the market. Yeah, that I think the player base would like riot, chat. Because you would have so many, granted, Konami reprints everything into oblivion now. It's really difficult to have like a high value card. But let's just say, chat, tomorrow, your Starlight Rare Opelousas is effectively banned. I mean, you can still play it at locals, but you can't play it at any regionals. You can't play it at any YCSs. I think people would be upset about that, chat. You guys remember what was that deck? Like, Performages and Pals, you guys remember that? When Konami had the emergency ban list, but they called it an adjusted ban list. And they basically like e-banned a lot of the cards in Pepe. Like, I think it was only legal at like one Shonen Jump, or excuse me, YCS at Atlanta. And all the Pepe players were like, we only got to play our deck for 3 weeks. This is so unfair. So you guys get what I'm saying. Yeah, rip Plush Fire. Yeah, they hit like what? Plush Fire, Damage Juggler, Luster Pendulum with the one. They hit like a ton of fucking cards. And the Pepe players were all complained because they were like, we only got 3 weeks to play the deck. Like, what the fuck, Konami? What's up, Lion Kingdom? Dude, I was literally thinking about this topic when I got the notification you were live. Well, I thought about it because I was thinking about the new Megaton cards and how they're like not good. But then Super Canadian was like, well, if you make them good, then they're just, it's just more of you can't play Yu-Gi-Oh. And it's like, dude, they're just, Konami has just backed themselves into the corner, chat, with so much power creep that they can't get the fuck out. Like, all the options to get out are bad. They don't reprint Dragon Maids. Another problem with set rotation in Yu-Gi-Oh! Is that they profit off legacy support. Oh, shit. Eight, I didn't even think. Holy shit, chat. Dude, how the hell do these other how the hell do these other games even work then, chat? So, yeah. All right. You're basically saying if Konami comes out with, like, Dragon Maids, you only get to play them for 1 year, and then you just never get to play Dragon Maids again, because you can't make five more new Dragon Maid cards like a year and a half from now, because you wouldn't be able to play the old cards because of set rotation. Like, how the fuck does set rotation even work then? Because yeah, Yu-Gi-Oh has way too many archetypes. We have hundreds of look at the archetype voting we've had in the last 2 years, chat. None of that would be possible if we had set rotation. Like, you want a new Shadow structure deck? Okay, well, you can't play Shadows because they're an archetype from 2015. So, can't play them again. You got to play Doll Dolls or some other new shit that Konami makes up. I really didn't even think about legacy support. If you have legacy support, you can't really, like, it really wouldn't work. You know what I mean? Have I seen the speculation with Magistus? The fourth mage, maybe Kita's relative. I would probably just say no, because the Charmers, the Charmers are not related to the, what do we even call that, like, what do you call that, that lore? Look, I can just, that shouldn't be it. Charmers are part of, like, Dual Terminal, if I'm not mistaken, chat, I think so. But, like, that lore has invoked prophecy. It's like invoked prophecy and Demeon invoked and some other archetype, I'm thinking. Maybe, you know what? That's what it'll probably be, chat. It'll probably be prophecy. Prophecy isn't in there. Pegasus, what are you linking me? I swear to goodness, if it's some black people fighting. Cap G is not. I am in no mood. Also, I can't click. Dude, did something? Okay, do you guys notice this? What did Twitch do? Why did Twitch change? Click the message to reply. I don't like this. Whatever Twitch did, I'm not liking it. Oh, this is a Farfa. You salty. I didn't even remember this. So yeah, I made a video. The good old days, chat. Press 1 to go back to the good old days of Yu-Gi-Oh! And Yu-Gi-Tubing, and these were the good old days. I was always on this side of the argument, if you guys don't know. When Pepe got emergency banned, I was always like, look, what the fuck you want, Pepe players? No one told you to go out and buy the deck. And I guess Nadir was on the other side of the argument saying, you know, I'm not going to watch a 30-minute video on stream. But I totally forgot he made a response.